Today, crews will take a new approach to free an 1,100-foot cargo ship stuck off the coast of Maryland. It's been sitting in the Chesapeake Bay for over 3 weeks. It ran aground in shallow water, and now the Coast Guard is hoping to finally get it to move by unloading thousands of containers off of it. It's a pretty big ship. Joe Khalil is live in Pasadena, Maryland, not far from where that ship is sitting. Joe?
Yeah, and we can still see it, Adrienne, over there. And as you mentioned, the operation to get all of those cargo containers off begins in earnest really today. And so you can kind of see, I think, from this view here, just on the other side of that ship, you can see those barges there with those big cranes. So what we're told is that they had to really dig those in like 40 feet underneath the water to make sure that they're sturdy and that they are firmly planted before they can start removing some of those cargo containers from that ship. How this is going to work is you're actually going to have two different cranes, one on either side of it, and they're going to start to remove those things one by one. What I'm also told by the director of the Port of Baltimore is that they're going to try to lighten this thing up, and if they start to see in the process that this ship actually starts to come a little bit loose and unstuck, then they may stop what they're doing, remove those cranes, and then bring back those tugboats that they originally tried to bring that ship forward. So they may not take everything off of it. If they can just take enough cargo off of it to lighten it up a little bit, that may be the way that they go, and then try to get it unstuck again with those boats. But only time's going to tell if the ship actually cooperates with them. So that's where we are now. I should mention that this process could take up to 2 weeks, but today we had real strong fog. The visibility was not great. If you can't really see it, they may have to delay, and it could go well beyond 2 weeks. But the hopeful expectation is that in about 14 days from now, Adrienne, they should have this ship moving again from where it is right now.
We've heard the company that owns the ship may not actually be paying the cost to remove all these cargo containers. Is that right?
So you see their name, Evergreen. They actually are going to pay some of it, but not all of it. Some of this cost is actually going to fall on people who own what is in those cargo containers. So some of it's going to be companies that are shipping their things. They're going to have to pay a portion of it. And actually, we also did confirm that there are some individuals that may also have to pay if they have things on that ship, but it's going to be proportional to what they have. So if there's only one container, it won't be very much. If you have a lot of stuff on that ship, you may pay a little bit more. Evergreen is going to have to pay the bulk of it, but they're going to be able to share some of that costs. It's actually an old maritime law that dates back like well over 100 years that is allowing the company to do that, Adrienne.
I was going to say, what is that about? But I guess they have to share the cost because accidents happen. All right. Joe,
yeah, it just dates back. I think a lot of people think it's a bit outdated, but that's the maritime law as it stands now. You might see some legal challenges there, but for now, that they're invoking it.
I think they just want their stuff back, too, so they're going to pay what they got to pay.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of NewsNation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.